Thank you for joining us for the two-minute drills. I'm Aaron Talegian, joined by Steve Ramirez. Steve, we have a big one going down in the Suburban League on Friday night. La Mirada, 4-1, 1-0 in league. They are playing Bellflower, 5-0, Stevie. 5-0, Bellflower. And Bellflower is 1-0 in league as well. It doesn't, you know, sometimes you need to manufacture storylines and drama in some of these leagues where you kind of have a good feeling who's going to win it before they even play a league game. And you kind of were getting that feeling with La Mirada, the way things are going this year. And we know Norwalk still is to come for both of these teams. But, Stevie, Bellflower, you can make a small case for, should have La Mirada's attention. Now, how long they do and how long, you know, it's a game is another story. But you're playing a 5-0 team, a team that's 1-0 in league. This is something that the coaches can manufacture, and we can manufacture as to, hey, man, this is no joke. This is La Mirada against an undefeated team.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, Bellflower is 5-0, and I think going into the year, you probably didn't think they would be in competition with La Mirada.
Right.
But, I mean, their schedule has been pretty easy for them. So they have a...
Freddie, thanks.
Thank you, Freddie. So they have a lot of confidence, but, you know, it's like Fred has said in the past, my whole argument is against who, and they really haven't played. La Mirada would obviously be 5-0 if they played their schedule.
Yeah.
But,
We had heard some rumblings about Bellflower getting some guys in and being a much better team this year than they've been in the recent past, and clearly that is the case. Yeah, they haven't really played anyone. I think the best two wins on the schedule are a 10-7 win over Pacifica and then a 40-14 win over Esperanza, which, boy, I think back in 2004 that would have been really saying something.
Yeah.
But, you know, still, I mean, that's a good win. They got them out of there fast. The rest of their games have all been blowouts, you know, the 45-0 type of variety.
Yeah. But aren't those teams like Esperanza, even in bad years, they're still good?
You know, Esperanza's fallen on a pretty hard times, Freddie. So, you know, I mean, they're 1-3 right now.
All right.
They're not what they used to be. But still, I mean, for a Bellflower, this is good stuff. And they can go in there with that kind of confidence. And undefeated teams are always dangerous. And you know Mike Muschietti won't be taking them lightly. And I just think that when you're a Muschietti and you're that coaching staff, you are looking for, to go back to it, that word, storylines or plots to manufacture drama for your team. Like, you better not take these guys lightly. They're undefeated and all this stuff. So I think you're going to get La Mirada's best shot. And La Mirada's best shot means Bellflower gets a dose of reality.
Yeah, I mean, and the one thing I'm sure Coach Muschietti is telling his team, a few years ago, La Mirada came in as kind of the league favorite. They opened up against, I believe they opened up against Bellflower, at Bellflower, and lost a tough game. And if I know Coach Muschietti, he's one to not forget stuff like that.
Right.
And he's probably going to remind his team. And they have looked so strong, except, you know, for the game against Servite. But Servite's one of the top 10. They're one of the top 10 teams in the state.
Yeah.
But other than that, they've kind of rolled through their schedule. And I expect that. Friday.
We've talked about this with other teams on other two-minute drills. You look at La Mirada, they're a one-loss team right now. If they do run league, they'll be 9-1 at the end of the regular season and a league champion. And when you start talking about that in that Southeast division, you're talking about, for La Mirada, probably a number one or a number two seed. There's a chance Lucerna is a one-loss team. There's a chance St. Francis is an undefeated team. So if La Mirada wants to be one of those top two seeds, it'd better take care of business and get, you know, a game like this and get it in fashion so that, you know, they can be a one or two.
Yeah, they cannot afford a loss because I don't think Lucerna is gonna lose the rest of the regular season.
Del Rio League coming up,
St. Francis, right. I think they can run the table in their league.
Right.
But it wouldn't surprise me if a Salesian or a Cathedral bit of
I think, maybe not Salesian.
Yeah.
This has implications down the road, is what we're trying to say. You know,
La Mirada wants to get one of those top four seeds. It just makes the road a little more easier for them, and so they have to win a game like this.
For me, I say forget top four. I think they want to get a top one or two, because in this Southeast division now, you start thinking bowls, you start thinking, you know, things that could happen down the road. And, you know, if you're 9-1 and then 13-1 when it's all said and done, and a CIF champion, you know, you have a good case to be made. And there's no reason why La Mirada can't dream big. I mean, they put together a very good season so far. So I got La Mirada winning this big. I'm sure they'll be quite aware of the situation, and they'll be taking Bellflower seriously, which is bad news for the Buccaneers?
Yeah, the Buccaneers.
So who do you got, the Buccaneers or the Matadores?
No, I got the Matadores. I think they're going to buck the Buccaneers, and I think it's going to be pretty big. I mean, I think this may be one of those games where La Mirada has to kind of sewed up at halftime.
Last week, right.
We may have a running clock by the fourth quarter.
You guys are unbelievable. This is a 5-0 team, and you're just talking about a running clock and blowouts.
Yeah, well,
I've got La Mirada in a close one, for the record.
Close one, Freddie says. Yeah. Close one. Okay, fair enough. Anyways, this game is going down at Bellflower, road game for La Mirada. That ought to be pretty cool. Stevie and I both picked La Mirada big. Freddie's got La Mirada small, and we're going to be right. And we hope all of you get out there and enjoy this one. Thank you.